Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom, and today I'm going to show you our top 8 tips for getting to websites quickly and safely, with a focus on some ways people get into trouble. We've broken it up into 2 videos, so they're not too long. This video will cover the first 4 tips, and the next one will cover tips 5 to 8. Searching, that is, using a search site like Google to find things, is what most people do first to find stuff online. Of course, search is incredibly useful, but it's also the riskiest way to get to websites. Search results can include deceptive and even dangerous sites, as we'll show you. But first, I want to show you a tiny change you can make that will save you a step every time you search. Say I want to find a florist in Albuquerque. Many people search in 2 steps. First, they go to a search site like Google.com, and then they type what they're searching for in the Google search box. You can eliminate that first step completely and search directly from the address bar. You probably know that the address bar at the top of your browser is sort of like the channel knob on an old-fashioned TV set. It shows you where you are now, and it lets you go somewhere else. The address you see in the address bar is the URL, that is, the specific web address of the page you're currently looking at. And if you want to go somewhere else, you just type where you want to go, like apple.com, in the address bar to go there. But many people don't realize that the address bar also has a third function. It's a search box. So you don't need to go to a search page at all. Just click or tap once in the address bar, and you'll see everything turn blue like this. You don't even have to delete what's there already. Just type right over it whatever words you're searching for in plain English, and then run the search by pressing enter or return or tapping go, depending on what kind of device you're using, and you go directly to the exact same search results page. It's a small change, but every search you do from now on will be a little faster. Tip 2, check to make sure you're using a reputable search engine. What does that mean? There are lots of different web browsers you can use to look at web pages, like Chrome, Edge, Safari, and Firefox. If that's confusing, check out our video linked above on how to choose a web browser. Then there are websites called search engines, which are sort of like the research librarians of the internet. They help us find things. And there are a bunch of those too. Google Search is the most famous, of course, but there are other search engines like Microsoft Bing, Yahoo Search, and DuckDuckGo. No matter which browser you use, when you do a search from the address bar, as you just saw, your browser sends the search terms to a specific search engine, which then sends back the search results. Just as you might have a favorite librarian to help you find things, every browser has a selected search engine. Which search engine your browser uses is controlled by a setting that can easily be changed. Here, for example, is how you find and change the search engine in Safari. It's very easy to change, and unfortunately, this setting can be changed without your knowledge to an unsafe search engine. If that has happened to you, you may see a search results page like this. It looks a lot like Google search results, but if you look at the address bar, it's not, it's something else. This is a common problem. If your search settings have been modified, all your searches may be going to a bad actor and your search results may not be safe. You'll want to fix that immediately. See the links in the description below this video for how to fix that in your browser. Tip 3, beware the ads. Scientists tell us that when given a bunch of choices, human beings have an unconscious bias towards the first option. When you look at your search results, the ones at the top are often ads. They're marked as ads, but it's easy to miss. It doesn't mean they're necessarily wrong or dangerous. The site you are looking for might very well show up in the ads, but just keep in mind that it's a good idea to look past the ads at the unpaid results. Some searches will link to videos or other kinds of content. It all depends on what you're searching for. This particular search has a section of map results after the ads, and then the regular results below that. So don't just click on the first result on the page. Scroll down and look for the most useful result. Tip 4, read the links. What does that mean? Let's use a real example that trapped some of our clients. Say you have an Amazon Kindle Fire e-reader that's giving you trouble and you need some help with it. You search for Kindle support by typing the words into the address bar, as we just showed you, and you get these results. Let's zoom in a little bit. Each of the results has a descriptive heading that is the largest and most visible text, and each result also has a link or URL in smaller type, which is the exact unique web address of the site. So because they're larger and more readable, we tend to look primarily at the descriptions. But be aware that whoever set up these sites can put whatever they want, including very deceptive information, outright lies, in the description, at least until someone notices and they get shut down. I could put best official Kindle support in the description. Doesn't mean it's true. What they can't fake is the link. Most people ignore the links because they look like a bunch of technical gobbledygook, but knowing just a little bit about how to read them can really keep you out of trouble. These links have a specific structure. There's something like https://// at the beginning and sometimes www. You can skip that part. Then reading across, you'll see a first single slash, and you can also ignore the stuff that follows that. The critical part is the domain name right here. Domains, like people, have a first and a last name. The first name is the company or organization. The last name tells you something about the type of site, like this. .com is commercial sites, that is, they're for profit. .org is normally a nonprofit organization, although that's not guaranteed. Anyone can register for a .org domain. .gov is official U.S. government. .edu is a school. .net is internet-related. And .mil is military. Domain names can also end in two-letter country extensions like CA for Canada, JP for Japan, and so forth. In the last few years, lots of other options have been added to this list so people can have domains that end in things like .info and .tv and so forth. You don't need to memorize all this, you just need to be able to spot that central part of the URL. Why should you know all this? Because it helps you figure out which sites are on the level. Here's my favorite example. The real domain for the United States White House is whitehouse.gov, because of course it's a U.S. government site. But people often assume the domain will use the more familiar .com ending. And whitehouse.com, although it's not currently active, did exist for many years, but it was a porn site. You can imagine how many unsuspecting middle schoolers went there by accident. And whitehouse.org is a political satire site. Now that you have a basic idea of how to read the links, let's take a closer look at the links in our Kindle Support search results. Here's the site with the address mykindlesupport.com. This name sounds useful and friendly, but it is not Amazon. It's not official. It's some random company that may or may not be trustworthy. Anyone can name their website perfectcookies.com. Doesn't mean their cookies are edible. Same with thefiresupport.com. Sounds nice, but it's not the manufacturer. This one doesn't even have its own domain name. They just created a website on Google's free website platform and gave it the description www.kindle.com/support. That's a pretty clever fake. If this were the link instead of the description, it would be more trustworthy. And this link to a Bloomberg News article is about how to get Kindle support. So although it's not Amazon, it is a reputable source. So that might be very helpful. But if we scroll back up, here's the actual correct Amazon website, which is where you should go for Kindle support. The description is rather dry, not nearly as enticing as some of the others, but you can see that the domain name is Amazon.com, the manufacturer of the Kindle, so we know it's for real. So the most important thing you can do when you look at search results is not be fooled by the descriptive name, no matter how persuasive it is. Always look at the link and make sure it makes sense for the site in question. So that's it for this segment. Use the link above for the next 4 tips on getting a website safely and quickly. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.